Hey everyone, my name is Ellen, and today I wanted to talk about my 5 tips for stopping that annoying buzzing sound on the guitar. So stay tuned if this is something you're interested in learning. So I've recently gotten a lot of new beginner guitar players on my channel because of my beginner series. If you want to check that out, make sure to click right here for episode 1. But a lot of the questions that I've been seeing in the comment section is about buzzing. You guys are playing it through the songs and you keep hearing buzzing noises. It's really annoying. You can't tell where it's coming from or how to fix it. So in this video, I compiled a list of 5 tips that I have for you to check out to see if any of these could solve your problem. My first tip is probably one of the most obvious ones, which is to make sure you are pressing down on your guitar strings with the right amount of pressure. If you are pressing too lightly, this can cause buzzing because what's happening is when you're not pressing down on those strings hard enough, the vibration for when you strum or pick or whatever it is you're doing with your right hand, it's going to kind of vibrate against the fret, but it's not going to be held down enough to have a clear tone. So that's going to cause a buzzing sound. I'll make sure to add a clip here to show you what I mean. All right, guys, so I've gotten a really close up for this first tip, using the right pressure. So basically, when you are pressing down on the strings, you want to make sure that you press down just hard enough that you get a clear tone. What you want to make sure is happening is that your string is touching the fret right in front of what you're trying to play. So in this case, I'm trying to play the 3rd fret of my low E string. I want to press down just hard enough that it's touching the fret in front of it. If you're pressing down too lightly, you'll kind of get a muted sound. And then if you press down too hard, you'll notice this string will bow in the middle. That's actually going to give you a whole different tone. So make sure you're not pressing down so hard that the string bends, but just hard enough that it's touching the fret in front of it. Now keep in mind also that if you press down hard enough and it looks like it's touching, but you're pressing a little bit too lightly, that's what'll cause that buzzing sound. So just press down a little bit harder and you should get a clear tone. So you could see in that clip, when I was pressing down a little bit more lightly, it was causing a little bit more of that buzzing sound. But when you press down harder, that buzzing sound goes away. So basically, the first tip is just to make sure that you are pressing down hard enough on your strings. I know from experience and working with a lot of beginners that this is the #1 problem that they have. You're not pressing down hard enough. On the flip side, you also want to make sure that you're not pressing down too hard. This doesn't really cause too much buzzing if you're pressing down too hard, but what it does do is it's going to increase your fingertip pain that you're feeling. If you are experiencing a lot of fingertip pain right now as a beginner, make sure to check out this video right here where I talk about tips and tricks on how to get over the finger pain that you're experiencing. So yeah, basically tip #1 is to make sure you're pressing down just hard enough so that you're not getting that vibration against the frets. And that leads really well into my second tip for you, which is making sure that you're pressing down on the right spot. Now on the guitar, there are these metal frets all the way down the neck, and you want to place your fingers in between these frets whenever you are fretting a chord or, you know, playing a song or anything like that. But something that really does help reduce buzzing is to make sure you're pressing in the right spot. All right, guys, so we're zoomed in again to demonstrate point 2. Again, you want to make sure that you are pressing in the right spot. So again, I'm trying to play the 3rd fret of my low E string. You want to play as close to the fret as you can to get that clear tone without buzzing. The further away you get from it, the more you're going to hear buzzing. So you want to aim for the middle between the 2 frets, if not right underneath the fret you're trying to play, okay? So that's going to give you the clearest tone. The 3rd tip I have for you guys is to make sure when you are playing chords that you arch your fingers. All right, guys, so we're zoomed in again so I can kind of demonstrate tip #3 for you. A lot of beginners I see are gonna play kind of more flat like this, and when you do that, you'll either hear a little bit of muting or you might even hear some buzzing, because what's happening is your finger is accidentally touching more than one string at a time. So the best way to fix this is to arch your fingers or turn them up, curve them, so that you're playing on the very tips of your fingers and you're not playing flat. This is going to give you more of a clear tone and make sure that your fingers aren't touching more than one string. Another good way to check this would be to play each string one at a time. If none of them are buzzing, then you're in the clear. If you're only hearing buzzing on one note, then you can also look and see what's causing that. Maybe one of your fingers is too flat and playing 2 strings at once, or maybe you're not fretting it close enough to the fret like we talked about in tip 2. So just make sure when you're playing chords to play one string at a time to see what the problem is. The fourth tip I have is to make sure you're paying attention to your other hand too. So far in this video, we've talked about your left hand and fretting and playing chords and stuff, but you also want to make sure your strumming hand or your picking hand or whatever it is you're doing with your right hand, you want to make sure that you're not using too much pressure on that as well. So basically, if you are strumming super, super hard or you're picking your strings like a lot and they're kind of bouncing back and forth and doing that vibration. Again, what that's gonna do is it's gonna cause a buzzing sound that's gonna be really annoying. And so what you wanna do is just make sure when you are strumming your chords to use a very light touch with your right hand. You really don't need to have that much pressure whenever you're strumming or picking, just enough so that you can hear the sound coming from your guitar. So in this example, I'm going to pick really hard. You can see when I'm picking really hard with my right hand, there's a lot more of that buzzing sound. So you just want to make sure you do a very light touch, okay? To avoid buzzing. Now my fifth and final tip is to take your guitar into a guitar shop to get a setup. It's very possible that if you have tried these other tips and nothing seems to work, you're still hearing buzzing after moving your hand around and all of that stuff. It might actually just be your guitar. There are a lot of things that could be contributing to that buzzing sound, such as uneven frets. Sometimes they're taller and shorter and things like that. And again, that can cause all of that vibration and all of that buzzing sounds. You might have a warped neck, or you know, the neck tension might not be right, and so that can cause the action of your guitar to be either too high or too low. All sorts of things can cause that buzzing sound, and it's through no fault of your own. So just double check and make sure that if nothing else seems to be working, that it's not your guitar. If you have a really bad case of this, you could actually go through and pick each open string on your guitar, and if you hear any buzzing when you're not even playing anything on your left hand and there's buzzing, that's definitely a sign that your guitar needs to be taken in for a setup. So to do this, just take your guitar into your local guitar shop and ask them to look it over and set it up for you. They will check all sorts of stuff like the action, like the neck, the tension, the frets. They can adjust all sorts of things to make sure that your guitar is in the tip-top condition so that when you play, you won't hear that buzzing sound anymore. Now, I do want to give you a warning that based on the quality of the guitar you have, your guitar expert should be able to kind of look it over and tell you, yes, I've diagnosed the problem, I think this is what's causing your buzzing, and yes, I can fix it. Or they might unfortunately have to tell you, like, yes, I know that this is the problem, but there's nothing I can really do about that. This is really common with more of those inexpensive, low-tier guitars, so just keep that in mind that, you know, taking it into the guitar shop is a really great thing to do for a setup, but it's very possible that they may not be able to fix the problem, depending on what it is. Some other things that go with this last tip that some people don't think about is to think about the environment that your guitar is in. Guitars should be at about, I think, a 40 to 50% humidity level. So if you live in a really dry climate, or opposite, if you live in a really like wet, humid climate, this could be changing the neck and, you know, the tension, things like that on your guitar. So again, this is something that you would want to have looked at by a professional and get your guitar set up. And another thing too is if you are changing the gauge, or again, the thickness of the strings on your guitar, this can really kind of set everything out of whack as well. So you want to take that into the guitar shop so they can look at that for you and just make sure that everything is set up how it's supposed to be for your purposes and for what you want to play. So yeah, those are my 5 quick tips on how to stop string buzzing. If you have any questions for me that I didn't address in this video, make sure to leave them in a comment below and I will try my best to get back to you. Also, if any of these tips helped you, make sure to give me a thumbs up down below, as well as subscribe to my channel so you can get more guitar advice videos just like this one. Thank you guys so much for watching. I really hope this helped, and I will see you in my next one. Bye!